Hi, and welcome to this 8th lesson in the B1 Usability Package Getting Started series. This is a bonus topic, and the reason it is that is because it's all about what we call B1 Printer Delivery, which is a way to do better email and print options. But it is an additional paid module that you don't get for free when you buy a usability package. You need to buy it on top with additional users there. It is worth its money, in my opinion, because you save a lot of time doing manual work in terms of print and delivery. But let me show what it's all about in this extra bonus session so you can gauge what it is. But it has almost a two-day e-learning content by itself. It's a huge module, but let me give you the introduction. So in Business One right now, I have turned it on over here in Productivity, and I've assigned myself a license, else it would say assign license. You can get a 20-day trial, just like the rest of the product, to figure out if you want it or not. So it's not set up right now, and whenever I go into a normal sales order, the normal SAP system will work here. I will press and I will see a crystal report. And if I were to email this to the user, I would need to export the PDF, open Outlook, create a new email, and so on and so forth in order to send it. SAP have options to send emails, but whenever they do it, it's using SMTP, meaning you can't really get confirmation that it worked or not. And there are certain areas where SAP simply don't do the things, for example, dunning. So with Printer Delivery, we are taking over SAP's emailing system and print system in total. We're still using Crystal Report, and you can use your Crystal Reports that you have made for the existing system. We just give you more options. So inside Administration, Add-ons, B1 Usability Package, or if you turn the module on, if you saw the first lesson in this, you saw it popped up a few times, but we have Printer Delivery. And the wizard wanted to say, hey, what do you want to use? So the first thing we need to tell is, where do we want to store the crystal reports? And I will write my crystal reports here. In a real system, you should of course have it on a --/ shared folder. But because this is a test system, I will just have this. And then you can see there's a checkbox for every place we support. So there's all the sales documents, all the purchase documents, finance, opportunities, business partners, banking, inventory, production, services, and things like account balances, which is customer statements, and Dunning Wizard. So let me do a very simple one and just say, let's do sales order and let's do account balance, nothing more. But you can turn every single one of them on if you need to. And this is just the out-of-the-box wizard. It will create some configurations for me, and those configurations I could change a lot. There's a lot of building blocks in here, a little like Lego box that you can build a very, very simple structure or build a very, very advanced structure in what you want to do. But let me do that. And open a sales order so we can see it in effect. So if I go here, and before SAP showed a preview, now we have taken over and chosen our preview. And you can see it's much faster than SAP's version because we have created better crystals than they have out of the box. So that was a order, but I can also press the email button. And what that will do is it will create a draft inside my Microsoft Outlook over here, where I control the text, I control the subject, I control the attachments that we can put on. So I can do it like that. I can save reports as well. Oops, wrong one. Or it's not really wrong, but you can see it just says the path to this is denied, and that is because my system don't have access to the path in here because it's a read-only path. But if I change that path into something that would be there, it would have worked. But let me instead do something and show you the customization, because you might not want to have it in that attachment part. You might want to have it in a different place. So I can right click and get into the specific configuration on sales orders by going into Brendan O'Leary and edit here. So I can go in and say, okay, whenever I'm this screen, use this crystal report. And I can control all the parameters to that. SAP only support these two, but we can support any parameter you want. And then we have the building block saying, whenever we press the print button, do this. Whenever we press the print preview button, do this, and so on. Whenever we press the PDF button, do something. So let's have a look at that one. And out of the box, it has something called report action. And if you've seen my previous video about universal functions, this is the universal function of a printer delivery system, because this is a set of different things you can do, an action you can do on something you want to deliver an invoice, for example. So in this case, it's set to save report, and you can see it's set to save it on the attachment folder. And that was the reason why it failed, because I don't have access to that. But I can choose, SAP will always choose there, but again, the option to have customizability here is pretty much endless. So I want to save them to my attachments. And then you can see I'm using this special keyword, again, as always, help. And then you can see the keyword overview. There's a bunch of special keywords in here. And one of them was this object name BP, meaning give the name of the type of thing we are working on in the business partner's language. So it would be in this case sales order, because it's an English customer, but it would be sales order in Spanish if the customer was set to Spanish. And then I can also say I want to open the file after generation, but also things like I could attach the file to the document itself. Right now that wouldn't work again because my attachment folder is messed up. But if I do that and press this button again, instead of an error message, it will pop up a crystal report as PDF. This is my PDF reader, just my browser. But it will show it exactly what it is, and it's in decode on my attachments, which was my choice here. And had I wanted it to say be a different file name, I could have used the dynamic syntax. You can see it says 8.0.0, which is this value here. And but I could choose to also put in the customer field here. Let's take the dynamic syntax of that, put it in here. And I could press now, and I would get it. Yeah, it looks a bit strange because spaces will show up as %0, but here's the 20,000. So if I go to my attachment folder, you will see it a bit better. There we go. So that is why we can do so much, and that's the reason why I can also go in and have a secondary option saying Whenever I press the email button, I would both show it and save it in here. So I could go in now. Now it would show as a preview and as a PDF at the same time. Not a scenario you probably want to do, but you would most likely perhaps save an extra file to be uploaded into a website or something like that, or a copy and so on. But where this really, really shines is around emailing. So if we look at the email report action, you have full control over the subject, you have full control over the body, you have full control over what the attachment should be called. We saw in here that it was my attachment that was called sales order, but I could call it whatever I want. I could choose that it was not PDF but a Word document or whatever export format Crystal Report can do. I could put in extra additional attachments in the system. I can fully control who is the two BCC and CCC, either by these predefined or with something called direct mail, where I can actually use dynamic syntax and SQL in order to find the email I want to. I can then choose the delivery methods. So I can either use Outlook and put it as draft before, or just send it directly. I can use SMTP, or I can use Microsoft Exchange, all depending on what I feel is the best opportunity for me. There's drawbacks and advantages for all of them, but you get the option, not just be limited to the one option that SAP have chosen. You can group emails if you do mass deliveries of things. So I could go in and in this mass delivery part here, go in and say, take my sales orders and send out every single one of them. In this case, 1200. If I set a checkbox, it will begin to create 1200 emails in my inbox. We can do advanced things like report selection, so I can actually set up that this business partner always preferred by print, this business partner always preferred by email. That's a system that I can set up with just a UDF on the business partner. And these are just the out of the box setup, and you can again tweak it as much as possible. So you could also, if we look at different options, we have the show report. We saw that. We can save the report. We can print the report. We can email the report. We saw that. We can also create activities. So if you combine this, you can say, send the email and create an activity that reminds the sales employee that is on that document in 2 days to follow up on that sales order. That is an automated system you can set up in minutes. You can send internal messages. Again, if a document has a very high doc total, it might be that you want to inform someone to take hold of them and thank them personally, or it could be too high a discount. That's up to you to decide, because you can do that, and you can do that with a conditional action. If you saw my advanced business rules, you can essentially just write a SQL here saying, if the document total is too high, if it's a VIP customer, if it's this and this, then have it do something special, send a more advanced email, send a mail with the promotion, send them, do whatever you like here. It's again building blocks that you can choose. We can also post to Microsoft Teams, so the sales channel can have an update every time a new order comes in, or every time the order is above this and this amount, you can do that. You can do SQL actions in order to set some special user fields to set that it's now been sent and so on. Or you can do a multiple action system where you just choose more than one report action. So lots and lots of options. I'm not going into details here, but just to inspire you that emailing from Business One doesn't need to be a a system that that is a high maintenance for, and a lot of people go in and do it. For example, in BioMIT, we are the creators of usability. We use this internally, and from you ordering a usability package or a BAS or any of our other products, to you getting the email, to you being able to see that on our portal, no human interaction is there. And the reason we can do that is because on top of we being able to take over these buttons, we also have a server component that can do schedules. So let's quickly look at a print delivery schedule where we can go in and say, let's send all sales invoices or sales orders using the email action. Let's send them every 5 minutes, the ones that haven't been sent. And then the server component will look every 5 minutes, say, hey, this sales order have not been sent yet. Let me send it for you automatically. And you can control every single little thing in here where you have a where condition saying, but it should not be the ones that have set their system up to print instead and so on. So that is a lightning quick tour of what Print Delivery can do. Again, huge. It's probably 2-3 times as big as any other module in usability package. It is an additional paid module because we feel like it will give you so much value extra. So try it out. Again, your free trial will give you access to it. And I am sure that you will see the cost benefit and the return of investment is very, very low in terms of number of days before you actually earn the money back. So with that, thank you for attending this session. See you in the next one.